Hey everybody, what's going on? Hellmite here, bringing you another video from Grab the Lantern today. Today I wanted to rewind a few weeks here, maybe up to a month or so, and talk a little bit about the State of Game Modes post that Riot released way back when. Now they did a big long Riot Please talking about their thoughts on featured game modes and what they want to be doing going forwards. Now I'm not going to break down that entire article, as I'm sure most of you have probably read it by now, but I did want to kind of go through and give a few of the thoughts and considerations that I had from reading that article myself, as I do think it's an important conversation to be having, especially as Riot gears up for next season and starts trying to plan out what they are going to be doing. Now, the biggest thing that came out of this article is that Riot basically said that they want to focus on amplifying champion fantasies as opposed to creating new champion fantasies in regards to different game modes, right? So, in that regard, they don't want to be creating a game mode that takes the focus away from what your champion does on their own. And now, the biggest thing I have, the problem I have, is I do think that's a good approach, right? You want to be focusing on what your champion does, because that way, no matter what game mode you play, you generally know what your champion can do with maybe one or two small tweaks. However, they also specifically said they want the champion fantasies as they relate to Summoner's Rift to be amplified, not just the champion fantasy in general. And now, this is pretty disappointing in my opinion. Because quite frankly, as much as I love Summoner's Rift, I play alternate game modes for a change of pace, right? To get away from the grind, to get away from the constant competition. Obviously, you know, even if I'm just playing normals in Summoner's Rift, it's still Summoner's Rift. It's hard to break out of that mindset of competition and trying to do your best at all times. It's a lot easier when you're on a different map or an alternate game mode and being able to say, it doesn't matter, right? This isn't Summoner's Rift, this is the Howling Abyss, or this was Twisted Treeline. All I can do is just have fun with it and play the game and maybe play champions I don't normally play or item builds that I don't normally go for, because this doesn't matter. It's easier to tell yourself that when it's not Summoner's Rift, you're not looking at the same three lanes and jungle that you're used to. And so focusing all featured game modes around Summoner's Rift means I basically can't take a break. The map is always the same, the shop is always going to be the same, maybe with a couple of small tweaks, and generally speaking, your champion is going to be always the same as well. That ends up being boring, as opposed to, even if your champion's the exact same, playing them on a different map can enable that champion to do a significant number of different things and sort of raises and lowers the value of certain champions in relation to that map. For example, for the longest time, Ziggs was a mid lane pick. You could play him on Summoner's Rift and he was fine, if maybe not the ideal champion in many scenarios, but on Twisted Treeline, all of a sudden, when you only have two waves to manage as Ziggs as opposed to three, he became a god tier champion because of his ability to easily wave clear out both waves, right? He can be in one lane clearing it, he can ult the other wave, and your opponents have very few abilities to push in. A champion like Darius as well gained new life on Twisted Treeline, as opposed to Summoner's Rift, where he was a lane bully, yes, but there's a lot of sort of counterplay, and he didn't survive very long in teamfights. In Twisted Treeline, where he only has three enemy champions hitting him as opposed to five, Darius could become an absolute nightmare of a pub stomp champion, and he became more than just a pub stomp champion, right? He actually had a life on that map. And that, I think, is significantly more compelling than forcing these champions to continue to see play on the exact same map where their strengths and weaknesses are generally known and respected. This isn't to say that I don't like the featured game mode set on Summoner's Rift. I think Ultimate Spellbook was a great idea, and I especially love the changes they're going to be making to it. But for Riot to more or less say all future game modes will be set here is pretty disappointing. Riot did also say that Earth and One For All have come back as much as they have because they're all centered around Summoner's Rift. Ultimate Spellbook did well, so it will also be coming back alongside those two. This is sort of the reason why those two game modes have been the only two we've been seeing, because Riot are trying to really focus around Summoner's Rift as the core of their gameplay. And while I don't think this is necessarily a problem, I do think that it's short-sighted for Riot to be trying to set up Summoner's Rift as the be-all, end-all. I think it's fine to focus on it as your main game mode, right? This is the competitive League of Legends experience. This is the core League of Legends experience, and this is what we're going to be balancing around. But for them to say this is all we have is short-sighted, because it does mean that you then don't have the ability of branching out and doing anything else unique or new or creative that I think can bring in a lot more players to your game. I think League of Legends does have a very solid competitive experience and draws a lot of very competitive players to it. But the biggest problem that League has right now is continuing to draw those kinds of players. Right now, it's very difficult to get into League of Legends if you're a brand new player because of how skilled the community is. If you're not encountering Smurfs, you're encountering people who are putting in the time and energy to get good. And if you're just here for a casual experience and you're trying to play the only game mode that exists, which is Summoner's Rift, you're just not gonna have a good time, period. That's just how it works. If Riot focus more on casual game modes, then they have the ability of bringing in these players and saying, if you don't like the core experience, that's fine. Here are some other game modes and things for you to do. I think that's one of the reasons why ARAM has been so successful for so long, because not only is it unoptimized for a competitive experience, because all champions are random, right? Who knows if you're going to get a good composition or not. But the map itself also contributes to not having a very defined meta. There are a couple of things you can do in order to exploit the map and exploit different things that are available to you, but generally speaking, your room for tactical or strategic growth isn't there, right? There's no way for you to really flex your strategic muscles on ARAM because it just doesn't exist, and so you're necessarily capped at your ability to perform well in ARAM. And that's a good thing because it means it's a casual mode, it is casual by design, and new players can easily play it and feel like they're having fun because they just want to play League of Legends, right? They just want to pick a champion and press buttons and have a good time and not have to deal with things like wave management and last hitting and item builds and that sort of thing. And now Riot does go on to say basically that a lot of these other game modes that they've done, especially the PvE game modes, have had very low player retention over time, right? A bunch of players start playing these game modes when they first come out, and then over time, right, once they beat it once or twice, maybe they decide, you know, well, that's fine, but I'm going to go back to Summoner's Rift now. And Riot have taken this as evidence that these game modes are not what the League of Legends player base is looking for, and therefore basically say, well, we're not going to do PvE game modes in the future. And I think that this is an oversight by Riot, because I think what they're doing is they're looking at the data and they're saying, well, people don't like this, so we're not going to do it. But part of the problem, and I had this issue with their handling of Twisted Tree Line and Crystal Scar, is that Riot doesn't support them. Right? And it does end up being sort of a vicious cycle, right? Where Riot doesn't support a game mode, so the game mode does poorly, so Riot doesn't support it because the player base doesn't have good retention, and so on and so forth until they eventually ended up removing some of the other alternate game modes that League of Legends used to offer. But I feel like the problem is that Riot are putting the cart before the horse here. What they should be looking at instead is, if we support these game modes, if they have constant updates, if they have constant changes and balance updates, and we're paying attention to what's going on these maps and what's going on with these alternate game modes and offering new experiences, do we have the player retention then? And part of the problem as well is that because Riot have been so adamantly cultivating a competitive player base that only wants to play Summoner's Rift, it's sort of natural that you're only going to have a community that wants to play Summoner's Rift. That's just kind of how that works, right? Whereas if you say you have these alternate game modes, and you put in the time and energy to developing them and cultivating them and saying these are always going to be around, you can build a community of people who want those game modes. And I think this is actually demonstrated very well in another Riot Games title, Legends of Runeterra. When Riot first did the Lab of Legends, it was sort of a hackneyed, slapped together. It was in the lab section. Riot has always said the lab section is for us to do crazy things and say it's out of order, things might break, things might not be balanced, things might never come back, but we're just trying it out. And this was a good way for them to try this out then, and when they got so much of a following behind it, because Legends of Runeterra at that time hadn't already cultivated this sort of super try-hardy attitude around it, right? It was a brand new game, and they attracted a community of people who just wanted to play the card game without having to always be looking up net decks or trying to hand-read their opponent or otherwise trying to play to their ultimate skill, right? They're able to kind of experience the fun lore interactions that the gameplay it provides, as well as challenge themselves in terms of what the game can do without the stress of trying to always compete at 100%. And look at Lab of Legends now. It's completely supported. There's all sorts of unique graphics and animations. They did a whole new version of Lab of Legends with the Gangplank, the Saltwater Scourge lab that they've got out right now. And it's because they cultivated it. They've updated it. They've provided extra value. They fixed things when they broke, right? Have added time and energy into this. And imagine what we could see if they did this for an event or for some of these other game modes that they came out with and then chose to not support, right? If you did balance changes for Overcharge, right? Or if you added more champions to Project Overcharge, or you added unique items, or you changed the map layout slightly, or for a PvE game mode like Star Guardian Invasion, if instead of having one playthrough and that's it, if maybe a couple months down the line, Riot added another map to play through, or some new rooms in the existing map, or some additional sort of challenge modifiers for that map, map. If you do it for long enough, you will cultivate a player base that actually likes those experiences and wants to play them, right? That's where I'm kind of getting at with how Riot have handled alternate game modes versus how they've sort of handled their competitive environment, right? You know that base Summoner's Rift is going to have a ton of support for it. New champions are going to be balanced by Summoner's Rift by default. You only have your professional series set on Summoner's Rift. Most of your alternate game modes only involve Summoner's Rift. So yeah, surprisingly enough, people only want to play Summoner's Rift because those are the players that you've supported. All the other players who like the alternate game modes you didn't support, and now they're gone, and now all that's left is Summoner's Rift. And so what I would like to see Riot do is I would like to see them actually take a stab at creating an alternate game mode and then providing constant support, and potentially leaving it up for longer than just a couple of weeks, right? Saying this alternate game mode will be available for 2 months, and we will give it constant updates, and we will do balancing, and especially I feel like the soil is ripe for Riot to do PvE and more lore-based things as well. I think that's the biggest problem I have with their current approach, is that there is so much that they're doing with the lore of League of Legends, and there's so much they could do with alternate game modes set around this, and instead they basically said, well, PvE doesn't work for us. But I think that if you did this, and you had an alternate game mode that's canon, that's set in the Runeterra universe, that you have constant updates for, that you do balancing for, that you try to market, and you maintain this, you will not only attract a ton of players to it, but you will attract more than you would expect because more people will show up when they realize there's something here. This isn't a one-off, play it, and then you're done. This is something that you can commit to going forward. That is the key for Riot trying to get more of this going forward. So those are sort of my major takeaways, and a bit of a rant, I would say. So let me know if any of this made sense down in the comments section below, or if you agree or disagree with my take on Riot and alternate game modes. I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts down in the comments section below. If you enjoy the video today, go ahead and leave it a like. And if you really enjoy the video, consider subscribing. I upload a video every Monday, Friday, and on patch days as well. Once again, thank you guys so very much for watching. I do appreciate it. And I'll talk to you all later.